We have two of Funko's Garbage Pail Kids Series 2 to unbox. And for those born in the 90s or later, what is a Garbage Pail Kid? I'll let this explain.
In the early 1980s, Cabbage Patch dolls were all the rage, even to the point where people were paying high dollar just to have one in time for Christmas. But over at the Topps Trading Card Company, something special was about to happen. John Pound took the Cabbage Patch Kids product and spoofed it by calling it Garbage Pail Kids. Around the same time, Topps was looking to create a new trading card line, and they ended up taking John's idea, and the Garbage Pail Kids were born.
So let's unbox. The box is a little bit bigger than usual because these figures are larger than your average mystery mini. First up is Kim Kong. And look, she's got a little banana accessory. Kids love accessories.
Toasted hot dogs taste like toast.
You got a one-track mind.
I got a fast-track mind.
And let's open the second box. And it's Richie Rich.
Why should we do something nice? Let's quit now, that's my advice.
We can do anything by working with each other.
There are 12 in this series, so if you buy a case, in theory, you should get the full set. So on first inspection, these are quite big, and they're quite heavy. But if you take a closer look, there's some quality control issues. Lots of glue. And that's our unboxing. And welcome to the news. First up, Cryptozoic. For a limited time, you can collect the DC Little Bombshells Series 1.5. These bombshells will be the same as the first series, however with new paint designs. There was recently a sneak peek at what are believed to be some of the Little Bombshells Series 2. There is no official release date, and sparse information has since been taken down from various websites. The release date for Ghostbusters Microfighters was expected to be in the fourth quarter of 2016, but they still haven't reached New Zealand. Touted as smaller and better than ever, there are 16 Ghostbusters micro figures to collect. Each blind bag contains one 1.75-inch figure.
Hey, anybody see a ghost?
They catch the ghost that won't stay dead.
Although they've been quiet for some time, the loyal subjects suddenly have a large number of series due out soon. First up, Dragon Ball Z were expected in February of this year, but are already out in the States. Series 1 of the figures have 12 points of articulation, accessories, interchangeable hands with different grips, a Dragon Ball, and the possibility of a piece for a Builder figure, Shenron. There are 11 in the series, plus the Builder figure. Next, How to Train Your Dragon are expected to be out now. There was a sneak peek of the series, which was in August of 2015, and the release date was targeted for November, but they never came to pass, and these were thought to be lost to the ether. Until now. All the heroes are expected to appear, however, one dragon is missing from the schedule, Barf and Belch. There's no idea how big the dragons will be, but the heroes stand at 3¼ inches tall. They feature approximately 10 points of articulation, have signature weapons and accessories, and a collector coin. It's believed the human characters will be in a case of 16, and the dragons will be in a different case of 12. And the chase may only be Calaverians.
They're Still the best.
G.I. Joe Series 2 are available in the States at the moment. Following up on the first wave of characters, Series 2 of the Loyal Subjects G.I. Joe action vinyls are back and better than ever. At least better than the predecessors. These 3-inch vinyl figures also include removable masks and helmets, 12 points of articulation, signature weapons, and there are 3 rare chase figures. Plus, vehicles are expected to be released soon. Yep, that's right. Not only can you display these bad boys, but you can also bring them to battle in classic G.I. Joe and Cobra vehicles.
We'll fight for freedom wherever there's trouble. G.I. Joe is there. G.I. Joe,
American hero.
There's expected to be a limited release April-May of this year for Attack on Titans figures. A full release at a later date is expected, but not guaranteed. There will be 7 figures, plus 2 Builder figures. The Builder figures will be 2 Titans, Aaron and Annie. No information on Chase, if any. Lastly, from the Loyal Subjects, Street Fighter are expected out in April of this year, but likely to be delayed. The final number of characters has not yet been released, but initial images show 10, with the suggestion there could be a few more to come. There's currently no other information available, and no chase are known. And in LEGO news, although a second series of Disney, as reported in the last episode, are still expected, these may still be a long way off. But currently available are LEGO Batman the Movie. These were released locally early January and are available everywhere. There are 20 in this set, making this the largest series of blind minifigures LEGO have released to date.
You think you're my greatest enemy?
Who else drives you to one-up them the way that I do?
Superman.
Superman's not a bad guy.
I like to fight around.
Are you seriously saying that there is nothing special about us?
There is no us. Never will be. Now, I gotta defuse that bomb.
And new from Jinx, Rick and Morty figures are currently out in the States. These are officially licensed, and there'll be 1 per pack, with 7 to collect. Characters include Rick, Morty, Tiny Rick, Summer, Happy Meeksies, Sad Meeksies, and Rick's spaceship. It's not currently known whether these will be released in New Zealand, but they're readily available on the Jinx website. Lastly, on to Funko. Beauty and the Beast mystery minis are expected out in March of this year. Although no New Zealand release date, it is expected there will be 12 in the series, but with Hot Topic and Walmart exclusive cases. Each of the exclusive cases will feature the usual 3 variants or different characters. Vintage Collection Batman were released in December of 2016, but only in the US. That's right, an entire mystery mini set of just Batman. Batman. Batmans? Anyway, the set is exclusive through GameStop. Standing approximately 2.5 inches tall, all the cases carry 1 in 12 odds. With 12 figures to collect and a dozen figures per case, completionists have a greater chance to find all of them. A sneak peek of the DC TV mystery minis was released for the London Toy Fair. There were 14 figures pictured, but this does not guarantee that all will be in the final release. There is no release date at present and no additional information. There are expected to be 12 in the set of Street Fighter pint-sized heroes, with the possibility of exclusive cases with a few variants. There is no release date as of yet.
Round 1, fight!
Although several anticipated characters are missing, we finally get an image of the retro arcade mystery minis. Boxes look great, but the set doesn't look as exciting as first expected. But time will tell, and still no release date. Lastly, Disney Pint-Sized Heroes have been announced. With 12 characters in the set, it's unknown, but likely, there will be exclusive cases for these. Also of note, it is believed the new ranges of Pint-Sized Heroes will have each character further hidden in a blister pack inside the bag, making them harder to identify by feel. And that's all we have time for.
I'm Todd, I work at Pop Fiction on Dominion Road, and we're a collectible peddler, so to speak. We've been open since August 2015, so just over a year and a bit. People coming in for the Pint-Sized Heroes, Garbage Pail Kids, Series 2 is just starting to pick up again. Five Nights at Freddy's, going like hotcakes. Yes, I am a collector. My bedroom is like a toy museum with a bed in the centre. I used to be a big kid robot collector, but Funko is where my heart lies. Yeah, the Garbage Pail Kids, when they came out, just relived so many memories of the Hades. So that's my series at the moment I'm chasing. I'm waiting for another couple coming out. A friend just told me about the Mystery Mini Star Wars figures, which I'm pretty excited about, but Kid Robot's also doing Mad Balls, which is another 80s throwback, which I am right on the heels of. Anytime, we're 228 Dominion Road. I'd love to see you.
It's competition time. How do I enter, I hear you ask? Well, it's simple. If you're already a member of the Facebook group, you already have one entry. No purchase is required. For additional entries, simply make a purchase from Pop Fiction during this month using the code BLINDERS at the checkout or in store. Also using the code BLINDERS adds to the dollar value of this month's prize.
Tune in friends alert! Tune in friends alert!
And welcome to another unboxing. I have three Kid Robot Fractured But Whole boxes to open. These were mentioned in the new segment of episode 1 of Blinders. There are 12 to collect in the set, with 20 to a case. There are 6 2 and 20s, 3 1 and 20s, 1 3 and 40, 1 3 and 20, and a chase. Although featured in several South Park episodes, the characters in these blind boxes are in conjunction with the Ubisoft game. And not unlike the Stick of Truth game, this one also seems to have an ever-changing release date.
We'll make way more money on our franchise! Go ahead, I bet you don't even get halfway through phase one on your franchise, DC Comics!
So let's unbox. And it's
the human kite!
The alter ego of Kyle.
That is so lame!
It's Professor Chaos, better known as Butters.
Prepare, little town. Prepare for the greatest supervillain you've ever seen, Professor Chaos!
It's Mosquito, the superhero pseudonym of Clyde.
Why can't it be Mosquito in France?
Nobody's f***ing heard of you, Mosquito!
These are the standard 3-inch. They have some great detail and a small amount of articulation. And that's us done.
That's all, folks.